Not just in this endeavor, but all the endeavors that he encounters in future. Congratulations, Deepa. Well,
10 odd minutes. It goes back to my childhood. I was a sensitive child. Well, now, maybe I was, how old, 10 years, 15, 12 years, I'm just guessing. I don't remember exactly. I'm struggling with my voice though. I am fundamentally happy, but my voice is not, right? So please bring it for me. I did my round with psychiatrists as well. For psychiatrists, it's very simple. Oh, you are suffering from clinical depression. Doesn't matter. Subah, sham, yeh, goli, this, goli.
Certain time they just spend for yourself and not for anybody else, not for your children, not for your wife, not for your girlfriends, not for anybody else. You have to be extremely selfish and say, this is my time. And I'm going to start this teeny weeny journey with me in myself. And then that becomes a huge journey. And for him, for the strategy, it started very simply and in his whole life. And he got so fascinated by it because it taught him so many things, it made him realize so many truths as such, that he realized that the pursuit of happiness is actually when you really meet the real you. Because when you are facing a public, when you are facing the mirror, you have many yous. Because it's time to go inside yourself and start understanding that that's the core of what everything is about. Happiness, about lack of stress, about being comfortable with your own skin, about being truthful. Because remember one thing, when you read things like the truth sets you free, you don't realize how true it is because you never actually bothered to tell it. But the truth is scary because you think that you make excuses not to tell it. You say, I don't want to hurt my friend. I don't want to hurt my husband. I don't want to hurt my children. So how can I tell them the truth? Because they're a bunch of assholes. And how do I tell them that they're assholes? You know, they get hurt. But the fact is that once you tell the truth, you're free. It sets you free. Because 10 years from now, when somebody asks you a question and says, what did you say at that particular time? You don't have to worry about remembering it because you never have to remember it. It always remains the same. You tell a lie and you carry it on your back like this great secret for the rest of your life. And if you tell one lie, okay, you're fine. Because you can at least remember it so that you can be consistent. But if you tell 20 lies, you will be very confused. And lying is a very amazing process. It becomes easier as you go along. It's like better. with looking into the mirror and practicing how to lie, you can do it with great conviction, trust me. But the only problem is that you have to carry it with you for the rest of your life, trying to remember what you said. Whereas you don't have to remember the truth because it will come back to you all the time. You know, and you'll be so consistent. And this is how Sahih. And once people realize that you're a mufat like I am, you know, then they don't get up. So how do they deal with my telling the truth? Yeah, it's pranad, he says everything. Okay. So if all of you practice being pranad for a while, you can say what you want and get away with it and be happy. That's how I'm happy.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
Very good.
I thought you were
going to be. Please come
closer. Like Gandhiji said, experiments with ourselves. I think all of us should write books about ourselves saying experiments with the truth. It's tricky. It starts off by being very difficult. But it gets easier as you go along because everybody says, go to Mukhpate.
Yeah, they said we like dieting together.
ये ख्वाहिश तो यही है ना, सबकी ख्वाहिश, आपकी ख्वाहिश, मेरी ख्वाहिश, सबकी ख्वाहिश ये है कि मैं हैप्पी हूँ। पर ये इतना इलूसिव हो गया है हैप्पीनेस कि ये सिर्फ हर्फ रह गया है, इसमें बिनी ही नहीं रही, क्योंकि हम इसकी पर्स्यूट में मेहनत करने को तैयार नहीं है। हम सोचते हैं कि हैप्पीनेस हमारा हक है और भगवान हमें देगा। अरे भगवान कैसे देगा यार, तुम जब तुम अपने खोजोगे तो फिर कैसे मिलेगा तुम्हें। शायद अगर 1% भी अगर कुछ सीखे इस बुक से तो वो बहुत है चैटर्जी साहब के लिए, बिकॉज ये किताब उसने इसलिए नहीं लिखी कि सब लोग को ज्ञान देने के लिए, किताब उसने उनने इसलिए लिखी कि उनने उनका जो एक सफ़र था और वो कैसे हैप्पीनेस पे पहुँचे, वो कैसे पहुँचे। अब वो ये कह रहे हैं कि जो रास्ता वो पकड़े वो सब सबके लिए शायद नहीं है। अब हर एक इंसान को अपना रास्ता पकड़ना चाहिए, पर वो शुरुआत होना चाहिए। अगर वो शुरुआत ही नहीं होगा तो फिर आप कैसे हैप्पी होंगे। नहीं नहीं, ये बुक तो ट्रांसलेट होनी चाहिए, ये तो बहुत बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट बुक है भैया, ये तो जो पूरी हिंदुस्तान की लैंग्वेजेस हैं उसमें ट्रांसलेट होनी चाहिए, बिकॉज इट शुड रीच एवरीबॉडी, बिकॉज देयर इज अ लेसन हियर। एक एक बंदे का जर्नी जो है वो सबकी जर्नी है। नहीं, आई एम श्योर अगर लोग पढ़ना शुरू करते हैं तो फिर दे विल वांट इट ट्रांसलेटेड, और वो हो सकता है, बहुत आसानी से हो सकता है।